Hey, it's April 23rd. It's a Tuesday. This is a Roger Williams Media Minute. Today, I wanted to talk about strategy versus execution. So in marketing planning and business planning in general, we talk about strategy a lot and, you know, getting all your ducks in a row and having a clear vision of exactly what you want to do and then executing on that in a nicely choreographed and timed and planned manner so that you deliver a consistent experience to the user and they, you know, love you and buy your services and hire you and all these great things. And the opposite end of that spectrum is just blind execution. So it's me getting in front of a camera, hitting record, coming up with what I want to talk about, and then kind of rambling on for a few minutes. Not that I would ever do that. And the, you know, the advantage to doing that is, hey, you know, it's in the moment, it's what I want to talk about, it's what I'm feeling right then, and I just kind of go with it, I shoot it, I record it, I post it online, and we see what happens. Which is the idealistic approach. In some cases, that just shoot and go, the run and gun method is great, and in other cases, it's horrible. Where it's great, if you don't have a budget for something or you don't have a lot of time to plan it, or it's something that's more of a side project or a hobby, maybe you're piloting, you're testing it out, the run and gun and just executing and going for it is fine. Also, if it's something that, you know, you're new and you're still uncomfortable and you're kind of working your way into it and trying to find your voice, just turn on the camera or set the pen to paper and just start writing something. You know, come out with a decent draft so that we're not just having to watch you pick your nose. I would never do that to you guys. I would at least edit it out. So on the other end though is the strategy. And while it's great to sit there and plan everything out and have all your KPIs and your ROI and your CBAs all ready to go so you can measure all these great things, well, what happens if you spent all this time putting together this great strategy, this great program that you're gonna run, and it hits the ground and absolutely falls flat on its face because it just for some reason didn't connect and it just doesn't work, or you've missed a window of opportunity where that content is relevant. And you've spent all this time creating this strategy and this whole program, and by the time you've launched it, it's too late. People have switched their focus to another technology. They've switched their attention to another topic. That fad has died off. Who knows? There's any number of things. Now, obviously, the big advantage to having a large strategy is that, you know, you're gonna have all these measurements kind of in place. And you're gonna also be able to go to a board of directors or a CEO or an owner and be able to put out a very specific plan and vision. And that is great and well to do. And that is something that I do regularly. But I really think that until you get some test data back, spending a whole bunch of time strategizing and planning is kind of spinning your wheels. It's better to, I think, get some content out there, throw some stuff into the water, see what bites, what doesn't bite, and then replicate the stuff that works. I don't know, that's me. I kind of have that style and it's evolving. But, you know, here's my email. Let me know what you think. The comments are down below. Which methodology are you more comfortable with? Do you like spending a lot of time strategizing, or are you more of a run and gun, stream of consciousness, impromptu, let's just hit it and go, type of person? What's worked for you? What hasn't worked for you? Love to hear your feedback on that. Tomorrow's Wednesday. We're cruising on through. It's warming up here in Phoenix. So we're starting to figure out how to escape up into the cooler temperatures up in Payson and Flagstaff and stuff. But we'll talk to you soon. Rock on.